핵을 보유하려는 나라와 비핵화를 주장하는 나라. 세계의 미래를 위한 각국의 뜨거운 외침은 늘 현재 진행형이다.
North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury.
그런 북한이 지금 변하고 있다. 남과 북 사이에 흐르는 평화의 물길.
한반도에 더 이상 전쟁은 없을 것이며 새로운 평화의 시대가 열리고 있음을 함께 선언하였습니다.
철옹성 같은 북한에 불고 있는 변화의 바람. 장막을 두른 듯 베일에 쌓인 땅, 노스 코리아.
We are at a very, very important stage in what happens to North Korea, whether this can be resolved within foreseeable future.
So I think that this government in South Korea sees a historic opportunity.
현재 북한은 대내외적으로 여전히 통제가 많은 미지의 세계다. 오랜 기간 이어진 독재 체제와 다른 국가들의 대북 제재로 점점 고립되던 나라. 하지만 2,500만 명이 넘는 인구와 중국, 러시아 등과 이어지는 지리적 이점을 가진 매력적인 투자 대상국 북한. 급격한 세계 정세의 변화는 미지의 국가를 세상 밖으로 인도했다. 세계의 자본주의는 이 신인 국가와의 만남을 어떤 마음으로 준비하고 있을까? 예상할 수 있는 시나리오를 들여다보자.
All right, Jim. On the last time you appeared on this program, you said that you wanted to go and invest in North Korea. Are you doing it now?
Well, Stuart, it's still illegal. I'd rather be poor and out of jail than rich and in jail. But as soon as it's legal, you know, I'm going to start making progress.
What are you going to invest in?
Well, I'll probably have to invest in South Korean stocks first. I own Korean Airlines for this, for instance, because there'll be a lot more travel when this becomes legal and open. And I'm looking for other things. At the moment, there's no stock market in North Korea. They're working on it. They're working on it, but it's not there yet.
But you want to get into any kind of joint venture, South Korea with North Korea. You want to get into it because you think there's going to be profit there.
Stuart, they need everything. They need electricity. They need soap. They need tablecloths. If you've got any kind of expertise, you're going to make a fortune in North Korea. It's where China was in 1981.
이미 직간접적으로 북한 투자에 대한 포트폴리오를 그려온 미국의 입장은 어떠할까? 전직 미 국방장관 윌리엄 코헨이 만든 컨설팅 회사. 실제 미국 기업들이 전략을 짜는 데 자주 활용된다고 하는 이곳에서 그 속내를 들어보았다.
So there are American companies that are exploring potential business opportunities. We think it's very premature to even think about that. There's so many overlapping sanctions on North Korea, restricting financial transactions, trade, and other activity with North Korea. However, some companies that have a British or Singaporean or other offices are welcome to explore that because they have diplomatic relations with North Korea.
전 한미 상공회의소 회장이자 아시아 담당 부회장으로 누구보다 한반도 정세에 밝은 태미 오버비. 그는 북한의 변화를 어떻게 보고 있을까?
What American companies would look for, they would look for North Korea is an untouched market. There are many American iconic American consumer companies that are everywhere. Whether it's Coca-Cola or McDonald's, Pizza Hut, KFC, Starbucks now, there are none of those brands in North Korea. Also, there are the U.S. is a leader in service, providing service. Our financial institutions, our telecom companies, all of our industries would love the opportunity to find an untapped market.
Secondly, on the investor end, the appeal for investors will be according to the specialty of the investor. For example, if you are an American energy company and your specialty is electricity, then North Korea is a potential market for you. Or if you are a mining company anywhere in the world, you would have the expertise that North Korea would need to probably put together a joint venture to benefit the mining company as well as North Korea.
북한의 개방에 있어 무엇보다 시급한 문제는 에너지 인프라. 이는 다른 산업들과의 유기적 발전과도 관계가 있다.
김정은 북한 국방위원회 제1위원장이 다음 달 10일 노동당 창건 70주년 기념일을 앞두고 북한이 청년 강국의 상징으로 짓고 있는 백두산 발전소 건설 현장을 찾아 완공을 독려했습니다.
북한의 김정은은 7차 당대회에서 경제발전 5개년 전략을 제시하며 전력 문제 해결이 경제 발전의 중심이라고 강조했습니다.
전력 문제를 푸는 것은 5개년 전략 수행의 선결 조건이며 경제 발전과 인민 생활 향상의 중심거리입니다.
특히 현재 북한의 전력 에너지 인프라는 심각한 실정이다. 석탄과 수력 에너지에 집중된 전력 생산량은 남한 대비 약 6%에 불과합니다. 이 또한 손실량이 너무 많은 상황. 세계의 투자자들도 이 부분을 주시하고 있는데 전 미국 에너지청에 근무했던 한 투자 전문가로부터 관련 이야기를 들어보았다.
We would like obviously to help North Korea get energy. Without energy they won't have communication blah blah blah. And we'd like it to be clean energy. So two basic choices. We could produce electricity in South Korea or anywhere else and ship the electrons into North Korea for sale. Or we could build the infrastructure in North Korea and they consume their own electricity. They're going to want the latter. They're going to want their own. But in the beginning, maybe what we can do is we can, the U.S. or others can help ship natural gas. We might be able to produce more in South Korea and send the electrons into North Korea. Ultimately, they're going to want their own their own infrastructure. But as you observe, that takes a lot of time and a lot of money. I think it might be more effective in the beginning to increase shipments of natural gas to the area and increase production in South Korea and just send it over the line to North Korea. And then as their consumption grows, their economy grows, their population wants more smartphones and more TVs, then you start to build up their infrastructure.
국제정세와 자국의 이익에 따라 여러 가지 가능성이 열려 있는 지금. 미국, 러시아 등 에너지 강국들의 신경전 또한 치열하다. 더욱 강력한 에너지 패권을 위한 소리 없는 전쟁. 대형 가스관을 통해 운송되는 러시아의 천연가스는 현재 아시아 대륙을 넘어 유럽까지 이어져 에너지 강국으로서의 면모를 유감없이 과시하고 있다. 이러한 러시아 천연가스의 강력한 경쟁 대상인 미국의 셰일가스. 영하 163도의 초저온을 유지하며 LNG 수송선에 의해 운반되는 셰일가스는 오바마 대통령 시절에 본격적으로 생산을 시작한 뒤 현재 사상 최대의 호황을 누리고 있다. 차세대 천연자원으로 각광받고 있는 셰일가스는 생산량과 가격 경쟁력으로 가히 혁명이라 불리고 있는 상황. 세계 에너지 시장의 판도를 흔드는 미국 정부의 에너지 정책은 러시아를 강하게 위협하고 있고 치열한 각축을 벌이는 두 나라의 다음 무대는 바로 북한이다.
I think they probably would be very keen to do that. I mean, as we say this morning, it's Russia and Germany and their pipeline, which is of debate. Very, very important geopolitical issue. Would I rather Russia sell them natural gas than burn coal? I probably would. But on the other hand, for example, in the United States, as we speak, we are now developing the largest energy infrastructure project that's ever been done, I think. It's called the Appalachian Hub Storage Project. It's the as opposed to Houston, where we refine a lot of, this is going to be here in the Appalachian Mountains in West Virginia, Pennsylvania, Kentucky. And it's going to ship natural gas and liquids out of Boston, Philadelphia, someplace on the East Coast. One could imagine, having North Korea be a destination that will generate huge quantities.
이렇듯 북한 시장은 미국에게 큰 가능성을 시사한다. 미국 천연가스의 수출국으로 멕시코 다음으로 큰 시장이 한국인데 이에 북한까지 더해진다면 엄청난 시너지 효과를 가져오는 것이다. 그러나 이런 핑크빛 전망 속에 간과할 수 없는 게 바로 개발 비용. 미국은 미개척지된 북한 땅에 자본주의의 마법을 부리려 하고 있지만 정작 북한은 국가 전체 살림살이의 4분의 1을 여전히 군사비에 쓰고 있는 실정이다.
If we could reduce the military defensive needs to guard against North Korea, that money could pay for a lot of nuclear power. And so if we could do that, many companies would be interested in helping build small advanced reactors in North Korea. In fact, many around the world would like to do that because we need to build them and get them faster and cheaper and smaller and safer. So one could think of a trade where the Asia Infrastructure Bank or the World Bank or IFC or others helped finance the deployment of advanced reactors, again, which North South Korea is already helping build themselves. And it could be a win-win. Frankly, I think the U.S. and South Korea would be great partners in many of these opportunities. And I think there's plenty of capital. It's just getting the right political risk and project risk taken care of. There's enough money to do this.
북한의 개방에 따라 에너지 인프라만큼이나 주목받는 것이 철도다. 철도는 단순한 운행 수단을 넘어 물류 산업에 꽃을 피우고 대륙과 대륙을 연결하는 문화 교류의 핵심적 역할을 한다. 최근 본격화되고 있는 남북 철도 경협을 동아시아까지 확장시키면 한반도가 명실상부한 아시아권의 경제 정치의 중심지로 발돋움할 수 있음은 물론이고 한주 한러 간 정상회담에서 철도 연계 사업 논의가 활발하게 진행되고 있는 만큼 철도 공동체 구성에도 속도를 낼 수 있다는 분석이다.
And I think once tensions are eased and things between South Korea and North Korea improve, I could see rail lines going through North Korea. It's been a while, but there used to be studies about how much time you could save by going, unloading ships at Busan and going all the way through Europe.
That, I think, is a fundamental principle for North Korean growth as well. So I would say that should be the starting point. And the United States has a lot of capacity in this area. I mean, even if you look at the Belt and Road Initiative, you know, I took out some statistics for Pakistan. Now, two of the biggest contractors in the Belt and Road Initiative, which is a Chinese initiative, are General Electric and Siemens. One is an American, one's a German company. Because they have the know-how and the technology and the ability to implement.
중국의 일대일로는 아시아와 유럽을 하나의 길로 잇는 초대형 프로젝트. 일대일로와 남북한의 연결된 철도가 만나 생기는 시너지도 매력적이다. 일대일로의 주요 수주사들 역시 남북한 철도 프로젝트에 큰 관심을 보일 것이 분명한 상황이다. 북한의 개방이 가장 실감날 분야인 관광. 잘 보존되어 있는 자연 경관과 5천년 역사를 가진 북한의 스토리는 관광 산업의 또 다른 히든 카드다. 큰 인프라 없이도 수익 창출이 가능한 매력 있는 시장.
They have great beaches. You see that whenever they're exploding their cannons into the ocean, right? So I said, boy, look at that. Wouldn't that make a great condo behind? And I explained, I said, you know, instead of doing that, you could have the best hotels in the world right there.
Tourism industry was very strong at the beginning, so.
Trump Casino in
Pyongyang. They need casino in Seoul first. So Western style hotels, so that Westerners can go there and spend hard currency in North Korea. So Starwood, Marriott, Hilton, all these hotels entered Cuba very quickly at the beginning stage. Also banks too, foreign banks to allow for transactions between North Korean companies and foreign companies. So if a hotel company wants to purchase land, they can do so through a foreign bank, not a North Korean bank, which they won't trust.
북한과 비슷한 예로 쿠바의 경우를 살펴보자. 쿠바는 오랜 기간 미국과 공식 외교 관계가 없는 소수의 나라 중 하나였다. 공산당 집권 이후 미사일 문제로 미국과 여러 차례 대립하여 50여 년간 교류가 끊겼던 미국과 쿠바. 반규와 함께 이루어진 금수 조치는 쿠바를 경제적으로 고립시키기에 충분했다. 오바마 행정부는 오랜 단결을 깨고 2015년 공식적으로 쿠바와 국교관계를 정상화한 바 있지만 당시 의회 설득을 못해 금수 조치는 풀지 못했던 상황이다. 당시 금수 조치가 풀리지 않은 상황에서 가장 먼저 쿠바에 들어온 게 관광산업이었다. 쿠바 아바나에 미국계 호텔이 들어선 것은 쿠바 혁명 이후 반세기 만에 처음이 있는 일. 양국의 경제 협력에 대한 기대감도 한층 높아졌다.
I mean, look at other countries in the world that have developed tourism from nothing. So Dubai, right? They have indoor skiing there in Dubai. They've got beaches that they made out of nothing, right? So it's possible for them to create something. There's also a curiosity factor too from North Korea. People are trying to go there now, today, even though it's not open for business. And also, I would think too that there's a lot of green space in North Korea. It's not as developed as South Korea. So if they planned it the right way, they could create, you know, eco-tourism or that type of thing that's very popular.
북한이 가지고 있는 자원을 얼마나 잘 활용하느냐는 성공의 열쇠가 될 것이다. 핑크빛 전망도 가득하지만 아직도 많은 국가들이 북한 투자에 조심스러운 것도 사실이다.
I think the biggest problem, though, in doing business in North Korea is making sure that it's going to be a safe investment. And in the past, North Korea has not always honored agreements with foreign countries, and sometimes they have nationalized or taken over foreign property. So it's still a very risky investment for a foreign company.
For example, the Egyptian company Orascom has experienced challenges in retrieving some of its investment out of North Korea. So this and other experiences point to the fact that North Korea's economy is evolving. As it changes, there will likely become more legal certainty, more protection for investors.
북한 투자에 시동을 건 나라들이 한결같이 요구하는 부분은 확실한 법률적 시스템을 바탕으로 한 신뢰다. 햇볕 정책의 산물이었던 개성공단 프로젝트는 대한민국의 기업가들의 투자와 북한 주민들의 노동력이 합해진 기대가 컸던 프로젝트였다. 그러나 본격적인 운영을 시작한 지 약 9년 뒤 여러 정치적 이유로 공단은 멈추게 되고 북한은 개성공단의 설비와 제품에 대해 국유화를 선언, 남한의 입주 기업들은 많은 손해를 봐야 했다. 한반도뿐만 아니라 세계도 주시했던 상황, 독자적인 경협의 새로운 모델이 절실했다.
So I think they should explore new possibilities. Kaesong was a wonderful idea. The problem was it was shut down constantly because of political differences, so it became a political tool. I would recommend that they try to find some alternate models, some that are not used as political tools by the North or the South, that would encourage North Koreans to understand the market economy and give them more experience with that, with working with foreign companies so that in the future they're ready for growing into entering the modern world.
But what I would suggest is there is, I believe, an unusual opportunity for South Korea and North Korea and American companies together, assuming these confidence-building measures work. But combine the workforce in North Korea, the natural resources, the mining, the other things that North Korea brings in the location, being able to cut through straight from Busan all the way to Europe, I think gives a very unique opportunity.
오랜 시간 닫혀있던 북한이 개방되고 세계 시장에 나서서 투자하는 일은 비단 수요와 공급만의 문제가 아니다. 한국의 발전으로 증명된 한반도의 성공 가능성에 투자하는 것이다. 남한 기업이 북한 진출 성공 사례를 만들어야 미국을 비롯한 글로벌 기업들의 투자가 이루어진다. 특히 기업들이 관심을 가지는 분야는 한국과 글로벌 기업 간의 합작 기업 형태. 이런 형태는 북한 투자국들이 가장 이상적으로 생각하는 비즈니스 모델. 문화와 언어, 민족성 등의 유대감을 가진 한국의 기업들이 글로벌 대북 투자에서도 큰 역할을 한다는 게 전문가들의 진단이다. 비슷한 언어와 문화를 공유한다는 것은 무엇과도 바꿀 수 없는 경쟁력이 되는 것이다. 이는 경제 개방을 먼저 시작한 중국의 예에서도 어렵지 않게 볼 수 있다.
And then President Xi's father is the architect of the opening in Shenzhen. And here was a man under Mao who was put out to, not out to the farm, but under house arrest. And his father started the experiment in Shenzhen. And the experiment in Shenzhen was to welcome foreign investors. And who came? Americans didn't come. Who came to Shenzhen? Hong Kongese, Taiwanese, people that spoke the language, people that had some ability to negotiate with officials, some ability to think, is this going to be true or not going to be true? Because they had the cultural and language skills that would allow them to negotiate, that would allow them to put engineers in the factories that could talk to the people.
So if you look at how China got its first steps in economic reform and growth, a very big role was played by Taiwan with the support of the United States. So Taiwan, which was culturally more familiar with China, was able to be, you can say, a conduit. You understand conduit, right? A route through which American expertise, finance, governance systems were all channeled, but with the Taiwanese knowledge of local culture and systems and patience and willingness to travel and take those frontline initiatives that American businesses were not. So for many years, till Hong Kong became a bit larger in terms of direct investment in China, Taiwan was the leading investor into China. I see South Korea, Republic of Korea, playing that same role. They can, with the support of the United States, play that role of transforming, of helping transform North Korea.
I absolutely agree with that. Any American, major American company will be very cautious in making any announcement about doing business in North Korea, and they will look for guidance from the U.S. State Department, the White House, but also they will look for guidance from the Republic of Korea. Most of those companies who would have interests are major investors in the Republic of Korea.
And that's why I think the South Korean companies will be the signal. If they don't feel it's going to be profitable or safe, nobody's going to go. And I think they'll have to be encouraged heavily by the South Korean government with various financial incentives and rewards.
세계는 우리를 대북 리스크를 가장 먼저 떠안는 대상이자 북한의 초기 인프라 구축을 책임져줄 파트너로 보고 있다. 세계 경제는 자국의 이익에 따라 움직이고 북한을 주시하는 세계의 시선은 동시에 우리나라를 향하고 있는 것이다.
I think what I would want to do is I would want to buy stock in South Korean companies who are going to do this work in North Korea. Yes, you all are so well situated to do that work. You know, it would be fascinating to see the ripple effects. It would be wonderful for the South Korean economy too.
So I think that this government in South Korea sees a historic opportunity. This opportunity is not new. There were times in the past when North Korea was in the same position, but all the other factors externally were not aligned. You know, you had relatively weak leadership in China, or you had a conservative government in Korea. Now, for the first time, you have a very assertive government in China that wants to make things happen. Mm-hmm. You have a North Korea with a relatively young leader saying, you know, I want change. He's experienced the success of a market economy. And you have a progressive government in South Korea, which is willing to take the risks on behalf of its people to say, yes, even if it costs us a bit, we will do this.
우리는 지금 기꺼이 북한의 최고 파트너가 되고자 한다. 어쩌면 그 과정이 험난해도 가야 할 길은 분명 존재한다. 우리 모두가 꿈꾸는 화합. 그 위에서 이루어진 소통과 교류만이 평화의 시대를 앞당길 수 있는 것. 세계 무대에 출사표를 던지는 북한. 세계가 바라보는 명실상부한 파트너 한국. 우리가 만들어가는 평화야말로 이 시대 최고의 비즈니스다.
You know, we want peace and stability, and I think certainly the U.S. and South Korea, and I believe that under the right circumstances, Kim Jong-un would also want a denuclearized peninsula. And we want to watch the standard of living for everyone in, on the peninsula rise. Peace is good business.